in the previous lecture we have discussed the hardware implementation and the flowchart for Boole's multiplication algorithm. Now today in this lecture we will discuss one example that will be solved through the Boole's multiplication algorithm. So first of all we have to draw the flowchart according to which Boole's multiplication will be performed. So suppose we have to multiply minus 9 into minus 13. Okay, so here this is minus 9 and this is minus 13. So initially we have to convert this 9 and 13 into 2's complement form. So here the binary of 9 will be 01001. It is minus 9, so we have to convert it into 2's complement. So now convert it into 1's complement first. 10110. Then add 1 to find 2's complement. Okay. So now here this is a multiplicand because it is a first value. So it is a multiplicand. It is a multiplier. Okay. So here minus 9 is equal to 10111. It is a multiplicand, so it will be stored in BR register. Next is multiplier. So multiplier is to be stored in QR register. So now find out the 2's complement of 13. Okay, so the binary of 13 is 01101. Convert it into 2's complement form. So it will be equal to 10011. So minus 13 in 2's complement form will be written as 10011. Now we have to multiply 10111 and 10011. We have to perform minus 9 into minus 13. We have already converted 9 and 13 into 2's complement form. So what is the here 9 is the multiplicand, 13 is the multiplier. So value of multiplicand, that is BR, is 10111, and value of QR is, that is multiplier, 10011. So now you can see that in flowchart we also need the value of BR complement plus 1. That means here subtraction of AC and BR is performed. AC minus BR. Okay. It is actually the subtraction operation. So we have to find the value of 2's complement of BR also. So find 2's complement of BR. It will be equal to 01001. Okay. So now perform the multiplication. Initially we have AC, then we have QR, then we have QN plus 1, then we have sequence counter. The value of sequence counter is initially 5 because the number of bits in the multiplier are 5. Okay. So here in binary the multiplier will be written as 101. So initially QN plus 1 will be 0. So QR is a multiplier, so write here 10011. Initially the value of AC will be 0, but we have to equate the number of bits of AC and QR. So write here 5 bits, 5 times 0. Okay. So now we have to compare the QN and QN plus 1. So QN is the last bit of QR. Okay. So we have to compare these two bits. Now you can see here that the value is 10. Okay. So now this is the case for 10. When QN is 1 and QN plus 1 is 0, you have to perform the 2's complement of BR and add it to the partial product AC. Okay. So here add 2's complement of BR to the AC. So 2's complement of BR is this. It is BR. Okay. So add it to the AC. What it will become? It will become this. Okay. So performing this subtraction, Now you have to arithmetic shift write the content of AC and QR as well. After that, the sequence counter value will be decremented by 1. So first of all, shift these values by performing the arithmetic shift write operation. So here 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, then 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, and Qn plus 1 will be equal to 1, okay? Because this bit is shifted to this position, Qn plus 1. So here SC will be decremented by 5, so it will become 4, and the binary value is 100. Here again compare Qn and Qn plus 1. You can see that Qn and Qn plus 1, both bits are 1 here. So simply arithmetic shift write operation will be performed and sequence counter will be decremented by 1. So shift the contents 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, then 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. So here sequence counter will be decremented by 1 and becomes 3. The value will be equal to 0, 1, 1. So now here again compare Qn and Qn plus 1. And 1, so for 0 and 1, we have to add AC and BR. So add BR with AC. So now arithmetic shift write the content of AC and QR. That will become 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. And the sequence counter will be decremented by 1, so it will become 2. The value of AC is now 1100, QR is 10110, QN plus 1 is 0, and sequence counter is 2, that is 010. So here QN and QN plus 1 both are 0. So simply arithmetic shift write of AC and QR will be performed. So here sequence counter will be decremented by 1 and it will become 1 here. Again, the value of Qn and Qn plus 1. This is our last step because the value of sequence counter is 1 here. So compare this bits 1 and 0. For 1 and 0, you have to add AC and 2's complement of BR. So here is 1 carry output. So discard this carry. So now perform arithmetic shift write and the value will become 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, then 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. And the sequence counter will be 0 here. Sequence counter is 0. That means the multiplication operation has been performed. So our final output is 0000110101. Now check whether it is equal to the result, that is equal to 9 into 13. So what is 9 into 13? It is equal to 117 with sign positive because both signs are negative. So both signs will be cancelled and the sign will be plus before the 117. So now convert this binary into decimal form and check your result. So it will become 1 plus 0 plus 4 plus 16 plus 32 plus 64. So it is equal to 117. That means our result is correct here. Okay. So this is all about the Boots multiplication.